Working with the animals, what was that like?
Smelly.
Smelly.
And stinky. And any other word you can come up to represent stinky.
Yeah. It was really cool, though, because a lot of the animals that you wouldn't think would be real, you'd think that they would make them on the computer. No, they're real, and we got to work with them, and it was really neat.
He's lying. There were no animals on set. It's all CGI. Yeah.
I know.
Okay, what animal would you never work with again after doing this movie?
We had a diva on the set named Toothy.
Oh, yes.
Toothy has an alpaca with a gigantic underbite.
Oh, my God.
And so Toothy became a little bit prima donna on us for a few minutes.
Yeah,
so.
We were trying to get her the rights to a trailer, but she wanted a bigger trailer, and eventually just got out of hand, and we just said, you know what? No, we're not going to do this for you, Toothy.
But we always let Toothy know we were rolling, or if it's, you know, because then it just gets pissed off, and then it spits at you, and that's not cool, you know?
Did it really spit?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it did spit.
You got spit on, I remember that. That was funny.
So which was more difficult to work with, Steve Carell or the animals?
Steve Carell. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just it's sad. I mean, it really. No, he's like cool. He's the most down to earth person you'll ever meet, and is totally unaffected by all the Hollywood life and the success that he's had. And it's just a really cool inspiration to kind of, you know, base what you want to do off of. So.
He likes to improv, so did you guys have to keep up with him on that?
Oh, yeah, I love it. I love the improv.
Yeah, I mean there's not that many movies where you'll go and they'll really want you to improv and be yourself and just go with your instinct.
Tom's smart in that way to where he understands that if you take it, you take a character and then, you know, match it against. My character is completely polar opposite of these two, my two brothers, and you know, he's kind of the cynical outlook on 15-year-old and just got moved to Virginia, taken away from his friends, and now his dad wants to build an ark. So everything's kind of just, it's like, what are we really doing here? And that's kind of his look. And so whenever you get with Steve Carell and bounce stuff off, you come up with things like the dance and you know, just all kinds of stuff. And Tom's really cool to let us do that.
So you think there's going to be a lot of extras that we didn't get to see on the DVD?
I hope so.
I'm sure that Tom will put him in there somewhere.
He'll find all kinds of stuff to do.
So what do you guys think about this being a spinoff or a sequel of an already huge hit movie? Does it make you a little nervous starring in a sequel?
Not at all. I mean, it's so different in its own way. It's
not even necessarily a sequel. It's more of like, it's like this is just the next chapter of it all. And then, you know, Steve Carell when Bruce Almighty came out really wasn't like Steve Carell at that point. You know, he kind of just started getting, you know, more notoriety. And
right.
And Tom's now taking that and adding to it and mixing it around. But it's just cool to work on, you know, not to get nervous about it and just have fun. And this is all just craziness.